Hi, you. How are you doing today? Welcome to Sims 3 Saturday. I know it's Saturday evening instead of Saturday morning. I did try, I swear, I tried really hard to get this up for you first thing this morning. I got up before dawn today, and I was going to be all clever. I got XSplit open last night. I got the Sims 3 open last night. I got everything set up, set the alarm early, woke up, came in here. Something the computer had rebooted, Windows updates, yay, and everything was shut down. I got it going again. You've got to wait for all these different things to start. And Skype, Skype starts up, and then the XSplit is not real quick. My Sims 3 takes 14 minutes to load because of all the things I've bought from the Sims resource. By the time everything got going again, I got a message through Origin or Skype or someplace. Somebody wanted to know something. I opened the program to find the information to send that message, and everything froze again. So I had to close everything down, start it up again. By the time you get through this process, I mean, I could have tossed something together. It would have sounded hurried and boring, and I just didn't. I felt like I'd be cheating you by just tossing something up. So I've waited till this evening. I just got home from work. I haven't actually eaten yet today. It's been a really busy day, but I'm going to do this first, okay? So we're looking at the Felinus family. Felinus family. I don't know how you say it. That's how I'm going to say it. I had gotten several messages after I started this house for people who wanted to see how I built things. I never thought anybody would be interested, so it never occurred to me to share that with you. But since some of you seem to be, then I'll go through that a little bit. Now, it looks like there's a lot going on here, but it's a lot of shell. There isn't a lot finished yet in the house. We've got this little courtyard here with the garage. These things really do evolve. This was not a plan. The only thing I knew about this family is I wanted them to have a house that was easy for parties. I think his life goal is to turn five other people into werewolves, and I can't remember what she wanted, but it had something to do with where I figured, having a good party house would make that a lot easier to do. So this house was all about comfort and convenience for having company over. And I thought, the outside, the pool, that makes it easy to, you can put a barbecue out here. People can move around. They've got instant entertainment. You don't have to worry about them too much. I've put in the hot tub over here. As you can see, I've got a different. Well, I have no mouse pad at all at the moment, and things are slipping, so forgive me for that. The garage, we've got a little bit of a, it's going to be at any rate. Let's get the roofs off. This is going to be like a little guest house at some point. We'll go down another floor, and there's the garage. That's all. Nothing fancy, no big deal. So we've got, a little fountain there in front, and the house is still empty. The house only is just a shell. So we have a, I think I was just going to have a cooking area in here, probably using, the banquet tables you can put up for company. Those are great because if people have a place to relax, if they can eat, they tend to stay longer when you invite them over. And I figure that's a good thing. So that'll probably be here in the hallway. I've just got, a bedroom for each of them, their own private bath. This is going to be a bathroom that everyone can use over here, because you want to wash the chlorine off when you get out of the pool. There's just a little shower house there that anybody can use. Seemed like a good idea at the time. So that's what I have built at the moment, and whether or not it fits what I want to do with it, we haven't found out yet. So we can just start putting some things in. I have a lot of items, and it gets kind of hard to sort through them. You used to be able to click on one of these things and just delete them in game, and now you've got to go into the Sims 3 login screen where they've got all the advertising for all the things you can buy from EA. And you have to, get rid of them in there. And not everything you get has an icon showing you what it is. So, I'm almost going to have to go through 2,700 things, pick out the things I don't like or what doesn't work in game, write the names of the things down, and then go back and find them. And it's going to be a horrible project, and I'm putting it off as long as I can. But if I'm going to keep doing these videos, I think I'm going to have to face the fact that it needs doing and suck it up and get it done. Now, color schemes, God, you know, I haven't even thought of that. Let's go find out what these people like, first of all. That would make them happier. You know, when I first logged these two in, they had turned into werewolves for the first time, and they were completely freaked out. They were stressed, they were embarrassed, they were cranky, they were all these things. And that's when I decided to put the big privacy fence up. I figured they haven't come to terms with their wolfiness yet, so that's got to be part of the story. So he likes gray and she likes blue. Okay, we can work with that. Choo-choo-choo, daylight, please. So, do-do-do. Come in the front door and be greeted by what? This is Party Central. All right, we'll start over here first, and then we'll add a little welcoming area there later. I'm just going to start with the kitchen. I'm thinking these guys are a little more modern than some of the characters I like to create. My next house is going to be a very old-fashioned Georgian place. I've created a family, and I can't remember what I call them, but I'm very excited about them. They're Indian descent. She's very traditional. She cooks, she cleans. I think I have her in a little apron. He's a little different. He wants to be a blogging star, a writer on the internet, and not that I would know, anybody that would have that goal in life. But I'm sending him back to university. He's going to be an adult that goes off to university. So that's going to be a lot of fun. And the daughter is, a young adult still living at home who's crazy about horses. So I'm personally going to have a ball with that. That's going to be great. And see the length of time for this stuff to load. See, this is why I'm not subjecting you guys to this before, because I think it's kind of too much. Now, I have been thinking about why this, ancient race of cat people. Felinus, feline Latin word, or Latin, I'm not sure exactly what it means, but I know it's related to cats. Why they would become werewolves. And we had talked about, they were cursed and that kind of thing. So what I've decided is that, it's really going to be a terribly, terribly tragic story. You know what? I'm going to put in some lights because you never really see the true colors of stuff before you have some kind of light going on. Is that big and bright and not very pretty, but let's just plop a couple of things in so we can have some idea of what we're creating and see, that's really ugly. Not going to work for me. So the story with the family is the wife fell in love with somebody that her family did not approve of. They're cat people. They've got that background and they're expected to marry other cat people. And she fell in love with a human. And she had to run away from home so she could marry him. And she had two young children. And in time, her family found her. Her father and her brother found her. And that didn't go really well because when they did, they couldn't get her to come home. Is that changing anything? Let's see, I don't think I'm gonna like this. No, this is not working on any level for me at all. So whatever color they like, we're going with something else anyway. So the family finds her and she won't leave, so they have her husband killed. Now she doesn't, they take her children and they're kidnapped and the children are raised by grandpa and she spends her life trying to get her kids back and all these, it's a very sad story. And she finally finds them when she's older and she's ill. And I can't remember why I have her die, but it was going to be just with her dying breath. She decides to curse her father for taking the life of her true love, for taking her children away from her that she hasn't seen until they were, young adults almost. And she decides to curse her father and her brother. And the way she's dying, she's ill, she's not thinking right. She curses her dad and his son, who is unfortunately her brother. And she said it in such a way, you know, magic can be tricky. There are schools of belief that says be careful what you cast because you're the first person affected by it. Or, you keep being bad is being bad, and there's always that karma thing. I don't know. There's a lot of stuff that can go wrong with magic, right? Sometimes it just blows up in your face. I've seen Harry Potter. I know this. So she sends this curse on her dad and his progeny, his son, and she dies without realizing that the way she had worded it, it would have come through her line and affected her own children as well, who are now werewolves. It's a very, very sad story. So we've got this werewolf, these werewolf children. You know what? I'm still not liking that. And this is why I don't let anybody watch me build, because I putz. The gray, the whole gray, and then the brown. See, now that's working. I can do this. So we've got this family of, or these brother and sister werewolves who were raised by their grandfather, and who have been cursed, in fact, by their own mother inadvertently. So that can't be a good thing. As one of you wrote in and said that, you think they should be kind of snooty and, based on their grandfather's history and, the fact that he thought he was the cat, he got to make decisions for the whole family, you can see why they would be that way. So that's how we're going to be playing these guys. Fridge, let's go for something awesome because I've given them pots of money. I don't know if I'll want that again, but yeah, I'm doing this kind of fast. You will probably find that when you come back, I've changed a lot of things because I sit and just I'll decorate one little area and make it pretty and I move on. And it takes me rather a long time to get this stuff done. And this kitchen is not going to be as big as I wanted it to be because I put that door right there. Kind of want a back door, but maybe you know what? Maybe not that one. It fits good, but it's just the back door, right? Let's just put. That's going to look really weird from the outside. Well, let's do it at least this far. And then we can add a little bit more space here for things like dishwashers and trash compactors. And those are important in life. If you've ever had them, you don't want to live without them again. So today is Earth Hour Day, and we generally pay attention to that around here. At about 8:15 tonight, I will be shutting my computer down and everything else off. They will go through the house. We get the candles out. We usually set up board games, and then we play games in the dark for an hour. It's kind of fun. Now, at some point, see all these colors that are uncoordinated? Nah, not my world. This is not going to be a, no, this won't work. It's not going to last for very long. We need a dining table. I'll put something small here where they can just tuck in for breakfast, and then we'll have a bigger dining area. Something kind of modern, I think. I like that. Well, I'm not sure I like that, but okay, what is my hand slipped off the keyboard. I'm in the wrong place. So if you guys celebrate, Earth Hour, I'd like to hear about what you end up doing for tonight during that time when we're actually off the computer for an hour. It's dramatic, right? No, not for these guys. Okay, I don't want to use something. Okay, you know what? Maybe. That might work. Now, the nice thing would be, of course, is if we could all get off our electronics a little bit more, says the girl who lives on hers. But I do think it's important to get off occasionally and go out and do something that's not, a complete virtual sort of thing. It's often a lot of fun. We call it board games that we haven't played in a long time, and it's a good time. Now, I only put one chair down because until I've picked out the color I want it to be, I'm not going to sit and have to drag colors into everything else. And that's why I did that with the cabinet. I pick out something I'm actually going to like beforehand, because I'm just not going to sit there and have to color each and every one. So I in a room like a bedroom or something where I've got a bed, maybe nightstands, lamps, curtains, carpet, you've got, your bed, your bedding, you've got other dressers, you've got a mirror on the wall, you've got frame, the woodwork or something that you might want to coordinate or at least have not clash in, some particular way. I'll put the whole thing down first. It looks horrible, and I know these are not the colors I want. And then I'll only put one of each. If I want two end tables, I just put one. If I want three lamps, I will put one. I will put one curtain up on one window and then color everything. And then, of course, just use the little eyedropper tool there to copy it and then pop those in everywhere else you want them. So for here, I mentioned this before. Let's see, entertainment, the party section. I love these buffet tables. You can pop those things down, invite a bunch of people over, have food sitting there. They'll eat when they're hungry, they'll ignore it when they're not, and everybody's happy. Now, I think this place is going to be the kind of house that needs a bar as well. Well, I want it inside or out on the patio, though. Yeah, there's not a lot of room in the patio. See, the one thing with this game, if you build things, you have all the room you want. They're not always easy to actually play because people have to walk for so far between this, that, and the other thing that metal. But I can change that, right? Is there any fun six in environment six? Are any of them any higher? That's lower. Seven in five. Well, seven fun. We got to go for big fun. Okay, so now these you can do a couple of different ways. You can set them up so that the bartender person stands behind it, and you can put stools here for people to sit in. I'm not going to bother. I figure they can grab their drink and toddle off. And maybe I'm going to put this on this side so this is a little more, you get the flow is better. You've got a lot of room. You don't have to be deking back and forth between the furniture here to get around in the game. During party time. Outside, I've got the hot tub in, I've got the little shower in. I wanted to put a barbecue maybe somewhere. Or things that are fun. I mean, we have to have things that are fun, right? What's going to be a good party house? Now, there are these games you can play in the yard. I could put in a bowling alley. A family fun water arena. Maybe not this house. No. A tanning booth. Holy cow. You can just get a tan. Awesome. These things are kind of fun. And I love the way it looks. It's so steampunk. I think that's brilliant. I like that. Barbecues or like fires, people sit around the fire and chat. I'm not sure if these are a sit around the fire kind of people though. I'm thinking not so much. What kind of things do they want for fun? A roller skating rink? Yeah, maybe. An old school DJ booth. Yeah, how big is that? That's gonna really get in the way though of moving around. Although I suppose I could extend the patio and sit it over here, but yeah, I don't know. Alchemy, drums, magic wands, a broom arena. So you have to build one of these at some point, and we can play hot, Quidditch. Whew. I went to say it, went right out of my head. A brain enhancing machine. See, that's what I need. That is clearly what I need. An ultra deluxe pool table. Oh my God, what a grim color. But you know what? I like the, will it fit any place? No. I would have to create a whole different patio with covering in the back for this to fit. Or that's what I could put upstairs. We could just have a pool room up here. Yeah, that might be a lot of fun. That's not horrible. I could just turn that into a little party place. People can wander up. Yeah. Okay, forget the guest house. We're just gonna have a pool room. Now for in here again. So we can eat. We don't have to starve to death. When you first come in, see, there's not a lot of room for just living here. These guys are going to be very much about what they're trying to build socially. I plan to have a lot of people in their home. But you need a place to kick back a little bit occasionally. You know what? I'm going to stick a television on that wall because, again, guests often just sit and watch TV. I love this one, but it's too big. That's pretty. That's kind of a sexy TV. I have built a few houses that had special TV rooms and put that great big one down and then build, steps and all the chairs. So you had your own little private movie entertainment area, which I personally would not mind having, let me tell you. That would be cool. Now, do I want to put chairs? See, I may end up taking this out. I think that might just mess up the flow here a little bit. Do we want a love seat or do we want chairs? And I'm thinking these guys are pretty modern. My next house is going to be very traditional, so I'm going for just utterly modern with this one. So if you just want to sit and watch TV, that won't be too terrible. See, coffee tables. Where is that one actually going to look like? Yeah, that'll fit. Once we get the colors set up, that'll be good. Oh, and if you have a coffee table, you can go back here and pull. Still with the voice. This is driving me crazy. Of course, I have been talking all day. It was so busy today. I have been just rambling since 9 o'clock this morning with no time for breaks and food and fun things like that. So my voice is kind of not as good as it could be even at the best of times. So there's a little place where you can sit and play games again. That's always fun for company. They like that sort of thing. I don't know if these guys are going to want any kind of skills. What should I put in here? What can I put in here? So you walk in. All right, what are you going to want to see? You got to have something that's like a normal house, right? And maybe I'm going about this all wrong with the kitchen area here. Maybe what I need to do, we'll take this out of the way. Maybe this could be like this. And this could, yeah, see that door. That back door is going to haunt me, isn't it? You kind of feel like you need a back door. So, this is where you go, well, what could I be doing? I need more walls. Maybe I just have to extend this, move that, grab this, get the brick, put that down, make sure it wrapped, and then take out this wall. Grab a window or two. We'll put in two of them. I like the light. And then just move all this right back, right out of the way. Because this was just not working for me. I didn't. That's not going to go by itself. I'm really sorry about being so creaky. I will get better, I swear. Keep the stove close to the refrigerator so they don't have to walk too far and cooking goes fast. And now that I've got a little bit of room, then I can just put a little eating area right here. That light is bugging me. Actually, put the light over there. I don't know. I still like it. And this is how I build in little pieces. Is it going to work? What's it going to look like? Oh, well, that's not right. So, and why isn't it going? Back it up there, darling. There we go. Okay, that helps, but I think I still want a little more space here. And did I do the same? Oh, I did the same with this one. Okay. That makes more sense. Okay. And when they're close, they snap, and that's that, and you just gotta suck it up and deal. Or maybe there's ways around it, and I just don't know what they are. I never bothered to look. Okay, that's working better. Because you can sit, you can eat. Yeah, that'll be cool. And it gives me a little bit more room in the front here. Still haven't decided what to do with these guys for pets. Do they want dogs around, cats around? You know, like the dogs would get on better with them. You know, I've been thinking I give them cats, and that'll make the cats hate them. Because they smell like wet dogs, right? I think I kind of like that. That may work out really well. I'm going to trash that and move all of this onto this side so I have a little bit more room to play around with how it's balanced. It just felt kind of tight there in that corner. Pull this out away from the door so you're not tripping on the sofa as soon as you walk in. Now, this is not a house I would care to live in, but I think it's going to suit the needs of my people. And one must take care of one's people. Even virtual ones who have really ugly fangs. So this space, I don't know, maybe one of them will decide to be an artist or they'll want a computer. I find I don't like putting the computers in when I'm trying to record because if they get in and play certain games, it just screams at you, and I have not been able to find any place anywhere that tells me how to get rid of that. It's just not working out. So this is the process. I'm going to want, I think, a lot of very modern colors. I was thinking about doing a lot of beiges or gray. Actually, he likes gray. That would work out really well. I went very clean, uncluttered look to this place, a couple of bits of modern art. Let's see what we can find for floors. What will we do? But I want more light before I start putting colors in because they change pretty drastically when you don't have enough light. And sometimes the best way to do that is just to stick a few windows in until you get all your building done. And then remove them as you need to. So, floors. Again, I'm thinking beige, gray carpeting, a white, kind of a pale wood, maybe. Just something that feels clean and cool. You know, and it's easy to clean up after the dogs. Oh, God. I don't know. I feel this family is either going to be a lot of fun or it's just going to be a series of bad jokes. I don't know which. Nope. No. Not for these guys. Oh, what's this? Well, it's pretty, but it's not this house. Which one did I try first? No, this one. Okay, so far, it's not bad. Nope. Let's go for carpet and see what that's going to be like. That's just white. See, that might work. Something like this. Okay, you know what? I need to put the walls down here. Actually, that's not dreadful. That might be the kind of feeling I'm going for. Although I was thinking more along or that. See, I like that. Blue, beige. Blue, beige. I tell you what, I like either one. You guys tell me which one you like. We can obviously change this. It works. For right now, I'm going to leave this one. Although that wouldn't again be Ava's choice. In a, but I kind of old-fashioned. I like English country. And English country with some decidedly modern Asian touches. I like bedrooms that are just quiet and sparse, and I like beige. I'm boring, I know. And green. Green is awesome. Okay, for the walls, I'm thinking just something like, would it be under masonry, rock, like a poured, I know what, I don't know what it's called. I know what I want, like that, something like that. I like that a lot. That would go really well in this house. No, I want the baseboards, although those were kind of big, but. Yeah, you know what? I want that sort of texture, absolutely. The color obviously needs to change, but because even if we go with the beige carpeting, this is too peachy. It's just not. I would want something a little more neutral. And if we're gonna go, see all this blue and white, I don't think I would be able to do that. I know I can't do that. I don't care what they like, it's not gonna happen. The kind of gray and blue, that was their two favorite colors, right? Okay, that works better. Actually, that's not bad. I think I'm gonna end up changing the cupboard, the colors of the cupboard though. I can feel it coming. Actually, this could work. This is feeling clean and cool. And then if we had the color of this changed up to what? Actually, the kind of dark. Instead of charcoal, it's more brown. Let's go with more gray, which means changing this one. That's just not catching up yet. There we go. Finally. Oh, I clicked instead of turned. So I changed the gray trim and not the gray wood, but you never know till you've gotten there. Okay, then go back to this one and make it a lot darker. Yeah, that's gonna work. And then I can take this wood and pull it down to this thing. And not that. Yeah, under here. Just coordinate a little bit. Looks like you bought a set, right? I like the metal on this, which I might end up, you know what? Let's move some of this up to the sort of brushed metal thing on the television and see what we can get there. And it's totally different. And sometimes that just happens, and you're going to have to sit here and play around with I have to sit and play around with the colors. And just see if we can get this, you know, more gray. As soon as it catches up. Since this one, and that looks like it's about as gray as it's going to go. But, oh well. I'll putz on it on my own time. Yeah, I think this family's going to be fun to play. And I have been building a few other families, and I told you about the guy who's raised his daughter and now he's going back to university. So I think that's going to be kind of fun to play. what else have I built? Oh my God, I don't even know. I built several because I want to actually get a population in this town at some point so I can, you know, do something like, I don't know, play them. That would be fun, don't you think? Let's see. Do I want this clean sort of color? Would this be blue? Maybe this would just be blue. Not that color blue. You know, I kind of liking it just the way it is, which is rare. I change everything. Yeah, see, this color, as much as I like it, this has got that sort of, it's got a lot of blue in it, is what it feels like in that particular texture. So I'll probably end up changing it because it just feels out of place somehow. For curtains on this house, let's put the walls back up so I don't have any holes to worry about. What kind of curtains would this room have? Now the kitchen is right there. I don't know. Sometimes it works nice if you can coordinate when two rooms are that close together, but I'm not even sure. Yeah, see that, something simple. I kind of like that. Did I get it right in one? That's not good. That couldn't happen. That just couldn't possibly happen. But I do kind of like it. Yeah, you know what? This is the look that I'm hoping. This is good. I'm done. That will be awesome. And then it won't matter what I put in the kitchen because it won't matter what I put in the kitchen. And quite frankly, the kitchen may not have much of anything in it. I mean, if it's looking out on your own back door and you want that clean, open look, there have been times when, you look at a window, the window's kind of cool all by itself. Maybe it doesn't need a window covering. It's just fine as it is. Now, because I know me, for all the clean and wonderful and sparse and, just uncluttered look I want, I will bet you that at some point I put down a carpet somewhere. Because Ava loves her carpets. No, it would be something bigger. I download a lot of carpets. Just something for some color and splash, although it wouldn't be that sort. I think with this lot, I'd want something. Well, even something, not that one, but more like that than the other. Wrong colors, but that could be awesome. See, that's the kind of carpet I'd go for. I like that. Not so much. Oh, look at this. This might be just kind of brilliant. Look at that. It's perfect. It's got that modern look. It still feels clean and it, and yeah, and then I'm looking at it and going, no, I think I liked it without it. So maybe it's just not the right one, that's all. We'll tuck that over here. Or maybe just not the right colors. No. Well, that's bright and cheerful. I'll put that one in my candy shop. I am so looking forward to building a candy shop in here to use up all that Katy Perry stuff. It's just going to be some kid's dream come true. Not me. I don't know. Maybe this is not going to have a carpet. I like carpets. I always like to have like oriental rugs and things like that around, but maybe not this time. Go figure. Maybe not this time, or maybe just not there. Under the kitchen. I don't know. I don't think it fits. I have a vision and I don't think it fits. As much as Ava would like to put it there, I don't think it fits. Okay, so we've got some outside wall here we have to get rid of. So here is the beginning of the Filinas family, their house. I have some bedrooms to do. I really don't know if you guys want to see any of this build stuff, so I'm actually going to stop here right now. And maybe you want to see the building of the house, although it's very much like this for me. I build a wall, I will, kind of block off an area, put down a couple pieces of furniture, see if they fit, and if it just isn't going to work, then I tear it down and move it. Put down a couple pieces of furniture to see if, it looks like it's going to work out. If you want to see the building of the house, say so. If you're interested in seeing this decorating part, say so. If you just want to see the people live out their lives, let me know. I'm sure I'm going to have answers that say all of those separately. I will do the best I can to make you happy, to make most of you happy, and to make the ones who are just that one single person that wants to see something, I promise I will try to do something for you occasionally too. I love all of it, so I don't even care. This is all awesome to me. I'm having a great time. Thank you very much. Have a great Earth hour this evening. Get off your computers as much as I would love to hit 1500 subscribers tonight, which is a definite possibility. Turn the lights out. Go talk to somebody. Take a walk around your neighborhood in the dark when it's quiet. Sometimes you come back to this stuff and life's just that much richer for it. So you live your life happy, build it beautiful. Please remember to hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. Your activity in here means a lot to me. It's keeping me going on those days when I get up before dark and don't have breakfast and try to do this and then don't have time for work. And now I'm going to go have breakfast here in a few minutes. So thanks a bunch. Until I see you next time, build life beautiful.